Hi, it's Carly McAvoy. I'm looking at some equations today, but I wanted to have them be in a context of English and word problems because I want you to see that equations are so abstract, but we can really put meaning behind equations, and then they don't seem abstract anymore. So let's set up a few equations here. Alex rented a car for $32 a day. The taxes he paid were $85.23, and the total bill was $341.23. How many days did Alex have the car? Now, some of you just might reach for your calculator and just say, I can figure this out without using algebra, which is true. But I want to use algebra because I want to practice that. What are we looking for here? We're looking for how many days he had the car. So I'm going to say D equals the number of days he had car. You can abbreviate it more than that if you want to, but I'm going to use a variable that makes sense to me for this. So what did he pay total? That's what our equation is going to equal. And what he paid all together was $341.23. So in these types of equations, there's three, and they're similar, so hopefully you'll be able to do the next two by following this example. Now, we had one thing that was a set cost, and that was the taxes. So that's just a fee that they tacked on to his bill, $85.23. Now, what we want to know is what's the other thing that he's paying for? Well, he's paying $32 how many times? Well, every day that passes. And so that's 32 times D. Every time there's a day that passes, he's paying $32. Plus he's paying his taxes, and it equals that. Now this is a two-step equation, which we practiced in the last video. So we can solve this. It has these with money a lot of times do have decimals in them, and that's fine. We're gonna do the same process. So what I'm gonna do is solve this equation. Remember, I'm gonna use addition property before multiplication, and that means I'm gonna get rid of this constant term, which is $85.23. And because this is an equation, I have to keep it balanced, so I have to do the same on both sides. Now I'm going to use my calculator because I don't want to make a mistake, and I love calculators. So I get $256. Maybe you could see that, or maybe not. There's a lot of glare here sitting in front of a window, but anyways, doesn't matter. I'm going to tell you that was $256, and then I have 32D left over because these were opposites and went away. Now I want to get my coefficient to be 1. I want to find out what did it cost for one day, or not what it cost, but how many days per day. Yeah, how many days he actually had it. That's what I'm looking for. So I want to divide both sides by 32. I'm looking for the number of days that he had the car. I can remind myself that by reading it. So 32 over 32 is D, and 256 divided by 32 sounds like 8 to me, and it is, my trusty calculator. And so I get D equals 8. So Alex had the car 8 days. That's how I would answer this. Now this equation type that we looked at starts to have meaning. Like, oh, okay, that's why you could end up with an equation like that, right? And of course you can check it. I'm not going to, but I could come up here, well, I guess I will, and put in for 8, I've got D plus 85.23, and 32 times 8 is 256, plus 85.23 is 341.23, which is what our equation was supposed to equal. I was running out of paper, I wasn't writing that, but that's what we're doing, right? We're just checking to make sure that both sides of the equation were the same. So that's my first example. What I would love for you to do is to try to do the next one on your own and then come back and see how you did. It's very, very similar problem, so you can use the last problem to help you set this one up. Bailey's last check. First step, read the equation, read the problem, make sure you understand it. Bailey's last check before taxes was $611. She makes $13.50 per hour, and she got a $125 bonus on her check for outstanding customer service. How many hours did Bailey work? So I want to know the hours that she worked. That's the question. So I'm going to call that H. I'm going to use a different color pen. H equals hours worked. And I could say H equals the number of hours Bailey worked, but I'm abbreviating it because I'm a little lazy. So what we did before was to say, what's the total? What's this equation going to equal? Well, there's three numbers, 611, 1350, 125. The total number for her check, a total amount for her check, was $611. What did she get that was like just a one-time thing that she got? Or maybe she gets it every week, we don't know. But she got $125 for her outstanding customer service. And then she also was making a wage per hour, and that's what we're looking for. So in addition to getting $125, she got $13.50 for every hour. I didn't put the zero on that. I could. It doesn't mean whether I do or not means the same. So now, if you weren't able to set up the equation, maybe you could still at least solve it. What would you do first here? We have to get rid of, remember we're trying to get the H by itself. So we have to get rid of 1350 and we have to get rid of 125. So what would you do first? Hopefully you remembered that you always do addition before multiplication, right? And so we're going to add or subtract first. That's the 125. So if I subtract 125 from both sides, I get 13.5H. And 611 minus 125 is 486. And then I divide both sides by the coefficient, and that's 13.5, or if you left it as 13.50, that's no big deal, same thing. And if I divide 486 by 13.5, I can see that she worked 36 hours. Perfect. If you did that on your own, you should feel good about that. It should make sense to you, though, that these are the kind of problems that you might actually encounter in real life. Not that somebody would ask you that, but I mean, it's a scenario that comes up. Somebody works in a certain number of hours, they get a certain amount of pay, plus they get bonus, and we can figure those kind of things out with algebra, which is so awesome. So 13.5 times 36 is 486. I knew that because of this over here. I wasn't doing that in my head. If you think I was awesome, I really wasn't. And then this 486 plus 125 equals 611, so that checks out. Okay, one more and then we'll stop for this video. And I would like you to, of course, try the problem on your own, because that's really where you gain the good experience, not just watching, but trying it. Mallory gets 5 reward points for every dollar she spends and 30 points a month for being a loyal customer. Last month, she received 11,155 reward points. How many dollars did she spend? Okay, Mallory is a spender. We can see that from this problem. So let's see. How many dollars spent? So I'm going to call that D equals the dollars spent. That's the dollars spent by Mallory, if I'm being a little bit lazy about that. How much did she receive altogether? Well, altogether she got 11,155 reward points. What was the thing that she got that doesn't change? Okay, 30, that's 30 that she got just because she's a loyal customer. And then what else? Well, she got 5 points for every dollar spent. Okay. So now I want to solve this equation. If you weren't able to set this up, you should at least be able to solve it by now. It's a two-step equation. We want to get rid of that 30 first because that's being added. So we're going to subtract 30 from both sides. And that's going to cancel out. So we have 5D. And then over here, we're going to have 11,125. I didn't even use a calculator for that, aren't you proud of me? Now I want to get rid of that coefficient. That coefficient is 5, and I always want a coefficient of 1. If you divide something by itself, that's how you get 1. Then I have 1D, which I just write as D, and I have to do the same thing on the other side because it's a balance, and if I do just one side, I'm throwing everything off. Now if I divide both sides by 5, I get 2,225. That means that Mallory spent $2,225 that month to earn all those reward points. All right, have a fantastic day. I'll